Hey Brian, I'm trying this again. I've got a surprise for you. I went to a Civil War battlefield today, a very small one. But what I wanted to let you know is that the very last images that I took was on a two-lane highway. I wanted to show you what most of Tennessee looks like, which is cotton fields. And the wind was blowing so hard that you couldn't hear my voice. So anyway, I hope you enjoy it. Bye. And here's the old cemetery, established in 1825. Hey, Brian. Well, here we are at the Battle of Salem Cemetery. Just wanted to show you the first sign here. And here we are at the Information Center, as you can see. And here is General Nathan Bedford Forrest. He was the commanding general of the cavalry forces, December 19th, 1862. And here's another battle picture and some Civil War artifacts. You can see those. And here's some just random pictures. And also, this is an unknown soldier. It says on the plaque, this unknown sentry stands guard over the hallowed ground in honor of the brave American soldiers who fought and breathed their last in mortal battle, December 19th, 1862. Here's something quite interesting, one of the cannons used in the battle. It may be a reproduction, I'm not sure. But here's one of the cannons. And here's the old Salem Cemetery. As you can see, there's a flagpole with the United States flag, and that looks like the flag of Tennessee or a Civil War battle flag, not really sure. Here's another cannon. Quite impressive. Like I said, it could be a reproduction. Wind's blowing quite frequently. I don't know if you can hear me very well, but here is the Battle of Salem Cemetery. Apparently it was a surprise attack. And it shows Forrest's second Tennessee raid. Here's another gallant stone. It says at the bottom, that it is, this memorial stone is dedicated to the gallant men of the Confederate Army, erected by J.B. Ingram, Camp 219, Sons of the Confederate Veterans. There's another stone. It was erected by the Sons of Union Veterans, Germantown, Tennessee, as a matter of fact, and the Salem Cemetery Battle Association, December 19th. 2000. Here's just random pictures of the cemetery. The sun's in my eyes, so I can't really get a good view of what I'm looking at. These are extremely old headstones. I see one back here dated February 11, 1756, and the person died in 1819. A lot of them are women. I can't really see anything. All I'm getting is my reflection. I'll see if I can get some closer stones. Apparently, here are definite several graves of unknown soldiers. And just take a look at the, you know, how they look. It's almost like they're not really graves. They probably were buried in shallow graves and just put stones around them. Quite sad. This is the tomb of the Garrett family. Looks like some of them may have been in the war. But this looks like a child's grave right here. This is an interesting headstone of a Jordan C. Holt, born in Bedford County, Tennessee, December 25th, 1822. Died in Madison County, Tennessee, October 8th, 1851. before the Civil War.
And this is just one last thing at the Salem Cemetery. This soldier was buried with, it looks like, tiny little cannonballs. All of these are unknown soldiers. And this is interesting right here, because a bush apparently has grown over this unknown soldier's grave. And there's the cannonballs. And this is the other side of the Tennessee marker. And it's the Battle of Salem Cemetery. And it says here, on December 19, 1862, Confederate forces under the command of General Nathan Bedford Forrest fought Union forces commanded by Colonel Adolph Englemann. After a cavalry charge was repulsed, the Confederate artillery forced the retreat of the Federals, and Forrest withdrew toward Humboldt. About 1,000 men were engaged in the two-hour battle. Thought this would be interesting. This is tour stop two. And this used to be a large oak tree. And it says it was at this point on December 19, 1862, that Colonel Englemann ambushed a column of Forrest's cavalry. They were forced to retreat out of rifle range after suffering a substantial loss. Their artillery was brought up and shelled, and the Federals withdrew until the Federals withdrew. Interesting. Brian, I got to show you this. This is what most of Tennessee looks like. Now, I'm on a two-lane highway.